So,
it's a stump just behind me there. I'm gonna start with that. I'm gonna go a little further back, but I can't put the camera down there. So, and I'm just kind of boning out brace height and knock height today. I'm just kind of trying to feel that I'm not sighting that much. Well, I'm not sighting ever, but I don't know, feels like quite good. Well, I don't think I need to touch it because, well, I've been beshafted at home, of course, so but as I said before, I only got like 7 meters indoors, so you need those longer shots to know how it goes sideways. And me, knowing that I have problems with my pressure point, I can do this and that sometimes, so I really require a high plus tiller or a high knock height. So, but that's also one thing with a bow, is really good, man. It's so easy to tune them. There's a stump there. So, did I wreck it now? No, there it is in the middle. Yeah. But it is so sweet shooting, so soft on the draw, it's almost unbelievable. The thing is, I really don't know the core material. There's something black going on here. I don't know, is that carbon fiber? Because it is fast and it requires stiffer arrows. So, well, man, I'm just under 8 inches brace height. I don't know, 3/4 of one. 7 3/4 of an inch or something like that. I really don't care that much until I'm satisfied with the bow. Then I measure it where I am. So, oh man, I got a lot of sticks in the way here. I don't know if you're gonna see me shoot. Let's try figure out the trajectory. Most of these arrows have glued, super glued in knocks, because I've been trashing the back end, so kind of super glue the knock in there. I can continue shooting with it. It's so quiet, so sweet. I mean, it's sick. I just love this little sucker, and I just started to shooting with it. Man, it's wonderful. Man, isn't it like everything you ever wanted? A short bow. Man, there's someone been here before. Wonder who that is. There's some trashed arrow sitting on the stump here, guy. But six arrows, yeah. Always have to remember how many arrows I have. But I think you're starting to get the picture about this plucky pin forest. I think this is a protected piece of forest, so they actually can't go in here and do anything. There's a nice one. I haven't shot at that one before, because I haven't actually seen it, so. Oh, it's shining in the sun. Well, hey guys. Let's see if we can get both me and the stump in the picture. So where is it, man? Oh, there's the stump. So let's see if we can get me in the picture. picture two here.
Looks a bit hard, so I'm gonna shoot low on the ground.
I almost hit my arrow.
Dang!
It's such a sweetie. I'm trying to keep down on the arrows, man, and only shoot three. So, I have to do some climbing. It was not a good idea to run in this forest with a tripod. But you see, it's kind of nice looking, this forest. It gets a special kind of look. Because there are like tree trunks laying all over, man. Oh, that's a nice, oh man, that was a nice stump. Check that out. Looks like a softy, eh? So let's go in here, guys. And you can see there's a lot of moss growing here, so that's what made me think that this forest is protected. Because there are tree trunks in here that has a lot of moss over them, so they have kind of, they just leave it be. I saw a very nice one here, but oh, there's another, man, I missed that one. Anyway, let's go back. That was a funny shot. Need to keep it low, guys. See that? There's a stump. Where am I? Where am I? Just behind there. That green bugger there.
They're quite soft. Well, of course there's some exceptions to the rule.
Always.
Didn't really sound that soft, eh? But man,
let's continue.
So then, man, it's sick. I hit my own knock. And how can a 56 inch bow have consistency, eh? I don't dare to shoot the same point, man, it's sick.
That is like it's forgiving, man, at 56 inches. Crazy bow. What can I say? Bang, Jim. Talking about hitting the spot, man.
I've been reading a lot about this. The thunder child. Thing is that Jim actually wanted me to review his three-piece recurve, but well, over the years this bow is big Jim for me. And when I read all the forums and comments, it seems like people, other archers, think that too. The Thunder Child is big Jim, and man, big Jim be proud, cause it's such a amazing little thing, man.
And little, man, that's just the size. It performs, I don't know, man, even better than anything. A lot of bows. It's fantastic, man. Check that out. There's so many stumps in between these trees, man. Oh, this is going to be wonderful when the chill is out of them stumps, because there are a few of them that are frozen, guys. Check that out, they're like, you see that tree trunk there? It's full of moss. Man, I think it's a fantastic piece of forest, man. It's like, what's that? Is that hard?
I don't know what it is. It could be a rock. Better not shoot at it. Let's find something, guys. I think it's a fantastic forest, man. There's another one of my arrows sticking up. I was here a little bit too early, man. There were rock solid frozen, those stumps, and I trashed like, I don't know, was it 4 or 5 arrows? The centaur is a beast. So there's one, man. A stick just in front of it, but I gotta shoot it from the left here, so. Maybe you wanna see how it looks like from the side. Yeah, let's do that. You can see me shooting it. Shooting. I have this English accent today. Could be that you don't see my limb tips. I need to be a bit further away. Wonderful with a camera that can turn the LCD screen so I can see myself. Man, I love this camera. So. Nailed it. In the spot, and I think the arrow is. I think it's laying sideways, man. I don't know. But man, shoot to the right, Greg. Yep. Ah, man, it's so goddamn, it's wonderful. It's so soft, and I thought it was quiet with those heavy arrows with an 190 point, but man, it's still so quiet to shoot with. Sick, man. Check that out, it's like, that looks like a rainforest. Fantastic. Looks like those fly fishing films from New Zealand, man. It's all green, man. The thing is that, check this out, it really sits good on my hook too. And man, if that ain't a plus, I think I could run and jump. Fantastic, but man, check out this forest, man. Sick. Oh man, I haven't been there yet. But it's like 20 yards. Well, like 50 meters, I think. It's quite a small forest. Doesn't go that far, but man. And I need to see that I can go there. I think I need to move my tripod up, because you're gonna have a really strange view sometimes down the ground. Look at that, man. That looks fantastic. But there's shots that I can't just do now, because I can't put the camera down. And I have to climb this. But man, that looks fun. This kind of, I don't know, feels like there are like targets everywhere, man. It's a bit cold. Oh, there's some. And man. Because it's, the forest is green, there's moss everywhere, and the stumps are kind of moss colored, so they're hard to see. Let's see if we can find something further away, but I don't know if it's possible in this forest. It would be nice to see how the arrows go, they are a bit heavier. I haven't measured them or weighted them, so I don't know how the GPP is. But I reckon it's around 9. Well, let's take that shot. It's not the perfect stump, man, but it's still something I can shoot at. Let's see. Find it in the picture. I'm hope you don't get seasick.
My camera. There, just on the right side of that tree there. You got a dark one. I don't know what that is. I think it's a stump. Shooting green arrows in this forest, not a good idea, eh? Can you even, I'm not too close. Can I go sideways a bit? I got some sticks in the way, so I'm probably gonna be cutting them off. So I hope I find the arrow then.
Oh yeah, they fell quite a lot. Compared to my 8 GPP arrows, but man, nothing severe. I think I can get used to this. My brain could adapt to it easily. Oh, that was a treat, man. But the bow performs so incredibly good. If I just did that. And I shot 4 arrows again. So, how do we get there? Oh, there's a ditch there. So, yep. Let's go climbing, man. One thing that I think about when I go over obstacles like this is that I kind of holding my bow out here, so if I fell, I throw the bow away, because, well, you know what Peter did with the Falco Force, man. Got stuck, man. He fell and we were on our way downhill. His feet kind of slided away underneath him and he just fell down. Man, deer poop and moose poop everywhere.
Oh, I nailed it perfectly. Oh, and that, I thought that was, oi, it's totally broken, man. So I hope I really don't care about the arrows that much. It's the SGA point I really want to find, because, man, where did that go? Let's take a break, guys. I hope it is in there. I need to dig it out. So.
That's not that interesting to look at, eh?